Yeah, it's good.
Okay, so thank you, Hugo. So my name is Eric Pernod, and I will present you the work of InfinTech 3D. So to highlight so far for Unity inside several features. So first, what's InfinTech 3D goal? So as Hugo explained this morning, on one side, there is so far with its main framework. There is also open source plugins and also private plugins with their own license. And the idea is to integrate the main framework of SOFA in order to evaluate all the features inside Unity and do the same for all the plugins, which might involve also some development support. And at the same time, always support the main framework of SOFA. And so how it is done inside Unity? So on one side, you have SOFA with all the components, the data and the scene graph and its simulation thread. On the other side, there is Unity with its animation thread. And in between, there is an API communication, which is made of C++ code that will wrap SOFA objects and also C# code that will map SOFA objects inside Unity game object and script in order to access that inside the animation thread of Unity. So this is a small example of the Caduceus running on the right on the SOFA main UI, and on the left, the SOFA simulation running inside Unity. So this is the Nova scene. And how it is done? So inside Unity, you will create a SOFA context game object. So this object will really create a SOFA instance that will run in background of your computer. This is the editor of view. There you can change the main parameter of the simulation, like the gravity or the time stepping. You have also some option to load either NixML or the Python scene file of SOFA. And here is a list of already supported plugins inside Unity. I will go over it, but not over all plugins. So if, for example, here is a quick simulation of tetrahedral lever falling on the floor. This is the same simulation, but with the GPU implementation. So you can see the speed up on the left. This is a quick simulation of the SOFA carving plugin inside Unity. So here we are carving into this tetrahedral lever. So using a lightsaber, it's not really accurate, but that's it. Then there's also integration of the multi-threading plugin. So here we are simulating 12 different deformable organs at the same time. And we are, so they have all collision and deformable models. And we are using a tool to move them. Sorry. There's also the support of the geomagic plugin. So here's a demo of two haptic devices interacting with a deformable lever. Here is the same view, but showing the tetrahedral FEM models. So you can see that we can interact with at the same time with the two devices. And so there is not only a mechanical simulation, but we can also integrate other kind of simulation, like the electrophysiology plugin, in order to simulate, for example, reaction diffusion on the cardiac model. We can also simulate some particle fluid using the SOFA SPH fluid plugin. So here, a set of particles are interacting with soft tissue, deformable soft tissue. And so there's several plugins integrating. So they could be either open source or private. I won't go over every plugins, but what is really important to understand is when you load a scene, a SOFA scene inside Unity, you have access to all the SOFA components and nearly the same scene hierarchy. And here I will show a demo of the interaction inside Unity. So this is the lever, the famous lever simulation. You can see on the left the Unity and the SOFA FPS at the same time. As I said, we can access the different components. You can access also their data, so meaning that you can change the parameter of the components. So for example, here I'm changing the mass density. You can also change the FEM models. So it's updating in real time. you can play with the visual model. So here I will change the rendering aspect, showing a wireframe view. So I can show you also the FEM models, just to show you that the rendering is done in real time, updating it in real time. We can also show the collision model. So here it's just a small sphere collision model. And this is another example. So here the soft tissue is simulated inside SOFA, but the cube is a Unity game object. So they are not running in the same, same simulation context. But what you can do is to map the Unity game object inside SOFA. So here I'm adding a small sphere collision on top of this object. Here I'm just changing the interpolation in order to add sphere collision on all the vertices of this cube. And now we see that when we play the simulation again, the soft tissue is colliding on the cube. And so the cube, which is a Unity game object, can be moved inside Unity. And we can see there is a similar interaction between the two simulation world, I would say. And so since recent work, we can also share the OpenGL context between Unity and SOFA. So this allows to provide more complex rendering plugins, like for example, the X-ray plugin. So here the X-ray source is controlled by Unity Cube, the small Unity Cube. You can see that we can also, so we can move it, but we can also change some parameters of the rendering. We can do also the same with the ultrasound plugin, simulation plugin. So same here, the probe is controlled by a Unity object, and the rendering is done in SOFA in background. So you can see that you can change the orientation of the probe and move it. And so the idea of using Unity is that we can use some, we can easily use some features available by Unity. So for example, here it's a project where the simulation is run on a computer and the user is interacting with a smartphone. And so the display is done remotely on the computer, from the computer on the smartphone, sorry. And here is another example of VR. So using the VR engine provided by Unity. So all the scenes, I mean the surgical room, are only Unity objects. And in the middle, there is a small simulation object of SOFA, which is a tendon and a knee simulation. So here I'm using an haptic device to interact with the muscles and also the bones. And so now a few words about the ongoing project. So unfortunately, I won't be able to detail everything, but there's a collaboration with the company Follow that will show their impressive haptic device just after me. The plugin in SOFA should be released next month. There's also a dental project. So here we simulate the tongue by a deformable body. The dental tool is simulating using a geometric device, and we can drill the tooth. I don't know if you have sound or not.
Yeah, we do, but we can mute it if you want.
There is also, sorry, still drilling the tool, the tool. There's also an ongoing project with from a needle insertion in there with Adrien Cortecuis, available soon in Unity. And finally, a last project on the capsule endoscopy navigation. So this is done in Unity using the high definition rendering pipeline. And so here the capsule is controlled by the Unity keyboard. And you can see that there is a deformation on the column when you're moving it. And for people who know me, I couldn't finish the presentation without speaking about topological chain. So here is a simulation of tetrahedral cutting on a liver. So successive cuts, full cuts. So I don't remember the size of this model, but there is some benchmark now still on full cuts of tetrahedral mesh. So on the left, I think it's 6,000, 4,000 to 6,000 tetrahedra. On the other side, 20,000 to 25,000. And finally, a last simulation of incision, so meaning partial cut. Here on the red dots, you can see the cut path. And you can see that the rest of the deformable model is updating in real time. So thank you for your attention. It was a bit dense, I'm sorry, but
it was the constraint of the format. Yeah, it's a bit specific this year, but thank you very much, Eric. I think you've got already quite a lot of reaction in the chat. You had people that I think liked what they saw. Some other uncomfortable with the drilling because they felt some pain. Please, guys, if you have some questions for Eric, do not hesitate. I will ask with one simple question: is there something that you did not address, Eric, after topological change, Unity rendering, VR? Yeah. I know what Eric is doing from closed loop, but even all the videos, I did not know each of them. It's really impressive. So it's a very, very nice work.
Yeah, very heavy tongue, yes.
Yeah, the tongue is heavy. Now, I've got maybe one very simple question is, what about the performance loss between, you know, a simulation which is run in SOFA and the one that you are displaying in Unity? Simple, but I guess it's...
Yeah, very good question. So there is indeed some copy of the data between SOFA and Unity. There's a lot of work ongoing to improve that. I would say in a few words that if you don't have a lot of heavy meshes, you won't lose a lot of performances. It will be only a few lost compared to what is the time spent on the simulation itself.
Okay, all right. Sorry, due to my sound problem, I need to switch between two windows. But yeah, okay, thank you. So the question from Clément, I'm going to read that loudly so that other people can, in case there is no chat, they can have access to it. So SOFA and Unity are both running on their own thread. Doesn't it lead to jumps on the animation when those threads are not running exactly at the same speed? For instance, 24 and 25 frames per second. Basically, how do you synchronize
both simulations? I won't be able to tell everything, but the synchronization is done taking into account the speed of each thread, in fact. So you have SOFA running on its own, which is a time-stepping value, and then on the Unity, you pick the update you want at the time step you want. I'm not sure if it's clear or not, but we can discuss more in detail after if you want.
Thank you, Eric. I saw Julien typing. Maybe Julien had some questions for you. Do not hesitate. Also, as I already said, take the mic, speak loudly, and anything if you'd like to ask a question to Eric. We have 2 minutes left, and then as it will be the case for Sylvain, Eric, and Frederick. You'll be able to, if you want a more private and intimate conditions to ask further questions, there will be, you know, the breakout rooms after this session. But yeah, please go ahead, Julien, if you'd like to ask your question. Anyone else is also welcome. I'm going to check if there is a hand with a raise. No.
Can you hear my voice?
Yeah, perfect. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. I wasn't sure. So I have a question about implementation on plugins with SOFA Unity. So if I have made a plugin implementing a plugin for SOFA alone, can I also use it in SOFA Unity after a few modifications?
So normally, yes. Theoretically, yes. But it really depends if you are using some other libraries, maybe, or I know recently I had some problem using also Python at the same time inside Sofa. But it really depends on the complexity of your plugin. But I would say for normal C++ plugin, it would be nearly straightforward.
Okay. So, for instance, some libraries made.c++ are not compatible with this plugin.
No, this is the opposite. If it's only C++, normally it's easier.
Okay, thank you.
There is people typing. There will be additional questions incoming. We have a few seconds left, but we'll take. Clément, I saw that you were actually typing. Typing questions. Do not hesitate to just. Okay. There is two questions. So, what about which platform are you supporting? And Sharam was asking the visual for the visuals for the lever.
I will answer the opposite order. So just for the platform, now I'm only working on Windows because when I started, Unity was more or less only on Windows. But I plan to cover Mac and Linux in the next month, and maybe one day on also Android. And so for the visual giver cuts, the last presentation was only on Sofa, on one Sofa, so it was not on the Unity. And there is ongoing work on to recreate the texture when you cut, when you do some topological change and cut models. So this will be improved soon.
Great. Thank you very much for the amazing presentation. I still feel a bit confused after so many amazing videos.